Hey there, how you doing, Keith? My name is Robert. In this guitar lesson, we're going to play a very nice song that's called I Think I Love You from the TV series Formation, The Partridge Family. Before we start with the lesson, I want to say that we do have a website, Robert Rocks the Mandolin. There you can find playing charts, chords, written out solos, anything you need to help you with the songs you're playing during these video lessons. My wife Cecilia created this all on printable PDFs, so visit our website. Let's look at the song. There's an intro, a verse, verse, a bridge, a solo, a bridge, verse, and a final chorus. And here's Joost, our movie star. Say hello to your fans, Joost. Joost has fans all over the world. He's receiving more fan mail than I do. So before we start playing, we're using a capo, capo, bar clamp, whatever you name it, on the first position of the fretboard. And now we're gonna try to play the song, starting with the intro. Play it out for you first, and then explain it. There we go. That's the intro. Sounds nice, doesn't it? So we're gonna play that. Start with the first line. D minor chord, one downstrum. And now we're getting the ring finger on the third position of the D string. Index finger on the first position of the G string. Back to D3. A chord, two downstrums. Hold the A chord and put pinky on the third position D string. Pinky away, D2, and one downstrum on the A chord. So one more time, first line of the intro for you, here we go. Line number 2 of the intro, D minor, one downstrum. Ring finger, third position D string, index finger G1. D minor 7 chord. So put the index finger on the two bottom strings on the first position and then the ring finger on the second position of the G string. D minor 7. Visit our website, there you can find all the chords you need to play this song. So D minor 7, one downstrum. A chord, one downstrum. And two more downstrums. One more time, the second line of the intro for you, here we go. That's the intro, we're entering verse number 1. Play it out for you and then explain it, here we go. That's verse number 1. How are we going to play that? Starting the first line, D minor chord, 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. D minor 7, 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. A chord, 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Line number 2, the first verse, A7 chord. So while holding the A chord, now move the middle finger away. A7, 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. F chord, 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're getting an F7 suspended 4 chord, 4 counts, 1, 2, 3, 4, G chord, 3 counts, 1, 2, 3, and now we're getting a G chord with an F sharp bass, so move the middle finger to the second position of the top string, F sharp, and leave the other fingers where they are, one downstrum on this chord. Back to the normal G chord. 4 counts. So one more time, the second line of this first verse for you, starting with A7, here we go. Line number 3 of the first verse, G minor chord, 2 times 4 counts. D chord, 2 counts. Getting a D suspended 2 chord, so move the middle finger away, 2 counts, one, two. Back to normal D, 4 counts, 1, 2, 3, 4. Line number 4 of the first verse, C chord, G bass, that's the normal C chord, plus the third position of the high E string, the G. C chord, G bass, 2 times 4 counts. G chord, 4 plus 1 count. Line nummer 5 op de first verse. G chord, B bass. So hold the normal G chord we just played, but we don't touch the top string now, starting from the B, the second string. 3 downstrums. And now we're getting a D chord, 4 times 4 counts. That's verse number 1. We're entering verse number 2. And verse number 2 is played almost in the same way. The first verse, only at the end, there's a small difference. So play it out and then do the explanation. There we go. There's a difference. The whole verse is played in the same way. The first verse, only the last D chord is 3 times 4 counts plus 1 instead of 4 times 4 counts. We're entering the bridge. Play out for you and then explain it. Here we go. Oh, take 2. That's a bridge. I'm gonna play that. We start with the first line. C chord, 3 downstrums. G chord, 2 times 4 counts. D chord, 4 counts. Line number 2 of the first bridge. D7 chord, 4 counts. A chord, 4 counts. A suspended 2 chord, so hold the A chord but move the ring finger away, 2 counts. Back to normal A chord, 2 counts. Now we're getting a B minor chord. But we also have to play between the B minor chords the F sharp on the second, so we're grabbing B minor chord including the second position of the top string. We're grabbing actually a B minor with a F sharp bass, but we're starting B minor, 2 downstrums, and now we're getting the F sharp bass, B minor again, F sharp bass, B minor bass, F sharp bass, B minor, 2 downstrums, F sharp bass, B minor, 1 downstrum. So one more time, the second line of the first bridge, starting with D7 chord, there we go. And this way, the third line of the first bridge, B minor chord, 3 downstrums. A chord, 4 counts. A suspended 2, 2 counts. Back to A, 2 counts, D chord, 4 counts, D suspended 2, 2 counts, back to D, 2 counts. Line number 4 of the first bridge, E chord, 4 counts, E7 chord, 4 counts, A chord, 4 plus 3 counts. Way. So one more time, the last line, starting with the E chord. This way. We're entering the solo part, the keyboard solo. We're doing the rhythm part of it. Play it out for you and then do the explanation. There we go. Thank you. That's a rhythm part of the solo. I'm gonna play that, start with the first line, E minor chord, 2 counts. And now we're getting an E minor 7, so hold the E minor chord and put pinky on the third position of the B string. E minor 7, 2 counts. A chord, 2 counts. A 7 chord, 2 counts. D chord, 4 counts. D 7 chord, 4 counts. Line number 2 of the solo part, played in the same way as the first line we just played. So here we go, E minor. Line number 3, played in the same way. E minor, here we go. E minor 7, A chord, A 7, D chord, 4 counts, D 7 chord. Line number 4 of the solo part, E minor 2 counts, E minor 7, A chord 2 counts, A 7, D chord 4 plus 1 count this time. There's a solo part, we're entering bridge number 2, play it out for you and then explain it. That's the second bridge. I'm gonna play that, starting with a F sharp. F sharp chord, 2 downstrums. Now we're getting a B flat chord, 2 downstrums. Move the B flat chord 1 position up. Now it's a B chord, and we're gonna play that down up down. So one more time, the first line. Second line of the second bridge, E chord, 2 downstrums. Now we're getting a flat chord, 2 counts, 2 downstrums. Move the A flat 1 position up. Now it's an A chord. And we're gonna play the down up down. So one more time. The second line of this bridge. Line number 3 of the second bridge. A chord again, 2 downstrums. And now we're getting a C sharp chord. So on the fourth position, 2 downstrums. Move the C sharp chord 1 position up. Now it's a D chord, down and down. And this way. So one more time. This whole second bridge for you in a slow tempo. Here we go. That's the second bridge. Re-entering bridge number 3. Play it out for you and then explain it. There we go. Bridge number 3. We're gonna play that. We're starting with the A chord, 4 downstrums. Here we go. A7 chord, 4 downstrums. G chord, 2 times 4 counts. D chord, 4 counts. Line number 2 of the third bridge. D7 chord, 4 counts. A chord, 4 counts. A suspended 2, 2 counts, back to A, 2 counts, and now we're getting the B minor again, including the F sharp bass, there we go, B minor, 2 downstrums, F sharp bass, B minor, 1 downstrum, F sharp bass, B minor, 1 downstrum, F sharp bass, B minor, 2 downstrums, F sharp bass, B minor, 1 downstrum. Line number 3 of the third bridge, B minor again, 3 downstrums, A chord, 4 counts, A suspended 2, 2 counts, back to A, 2 counts, D chord, 4 counts, D suspended 2, 2 counts, back to D, 2 counts, and now we're getting line number 4 of the third bridge, E chord 4 counts, E7 4 counts, E chord 2 times 4 counts this time. That's bridge number 3. Re-entering verse number 3. And verse number 3 is played almost in the same way as the other verses. Play out for you and then do the explanation. Here we go. That's verse number 3. The first 4 lines are played in the same way as from the other verses. Line number 5, small different in it. Starting with G chord, B bass, 3 downstrings. And now we're getting the D chord, 4 plus 1 count this time. In this way. There's a small different for the other verses. Re-entering the final part, the final chorus. Play it out and then explain it. Here we go. Take 2. That's the final chorus. I'm gonna play that. We're starting with C chord, G bass, 3 downstrums. D chord, 4 plus 1 count. Line number 2 of the final chorus. C chord, G bass again, 3 downstrums. G chord, 4 plus 1 count. Line number 3. C chord, G bass, and now we're gonna play that down, down, up, down. This way. D chord, 4 plus 1 count. Line number 4, C chord, G bass. G chord. Line number 5, C chord, G bass. D chord. Line number 6, C chord, G bass. G chord again, 4 plus 1 count. Line number 7, C chord, G bass. D chord, 4 plus 1. Line number 8, final line of the final chorus. C chord, G bass. G chord. 2 downstrings. The final line. That's to end the song. That's the whole song. I Think I Love You from the Partridge Family Explained. Very nice song to play on acoustic guitar. Absolutely not an easy song to play. It needs some practice. But hey, you will manage. So I hope you enjoyed the lesson. I did. And I hope to see you all next time. Visit our website, Robert Rocks the Mandolin. Take care. Ciao, tschüss, arrivederci, buenas noches, dos vidania, hardu, goodbye. And geen riff from Joost this time.